When the Savior reached down for me, when he reached way down for me, I was lost and undone without God's only Son. When he reached His eyes were watching me.
Psalms 37, and we'll start with verse 23. Say amen when you faint. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and his delight in his way. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholdeth him with his hand. I have been young and I've been old, yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging for bread. He is ever merciful, and his seed is blessed. Verse 27 and 28. Depart from evil and do good, and dwell forevermore. For the Lord loveth judgment, and forsaketh not his saints. They are preserved forever, but the seed of the wicked shall be cut off. Let's pray. Our precious Heavenly Father, we come to you, Lord, anoint me to bring forth this word and rightly divide the word of truth. Help me, Lord. And Lord, we pray, Lord of God, not only give us ears to hear, but be doers of your word also. Let them hear with the Spirit of God. It's got to say. We ask it all in Jesus' name, and the church says,
amen.
Amen. You may be seated if you can. The psalmist David says, I have been young and now I'm old. Yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging for bread. Why is the church world so troubled and shaken? Thank God. We need to be shaken to wake up. He said, depart from evil and do good and dwell forevermore. We're living in a time that, glory to God, that everything's been shaken that can be shaken. And sad to say, the church needs that great awakening. I don't know about you, but I hope that rivers of living waters will flow right to me. Because I don't want to miss it. In Luke chapter 22, Jesus delivered a serious warning to perhaps his most devoted followers. In Luke 22, verse 31 and 32, and the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan has desired to have you, that he may sift you as wheat. Verse 32, but I have prayed for thee that thy faith fail not. And when they are converted, strengthen the brethren. He's saying to all the church, he's saying, glory to God, just not to the Peter, but to every one of his devoted followers, that glory to God, Satan desires to sift you like wheat. Amen. He's out to attack every one of us. But I got news for you. If you just stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, don't blink, don't wither, don't go to God back down, but stand strong in His faith. Amen. Church, give the Lord a great hand. But very few Christians would be surprised that Satan wanted to test Peter. After all, scriptures present Peter as a leader among his disciples. It is no wonder the devil sought God's permission to come against this bold disciple. Scripture makes it clear that Satan's main objective is to destroy the faith of those who serve Jesus. Many, a lot of the churches are still not open. A lot of them are still closed. Amen, glory to God. I'm going to tell you, we got to do something. We got, amen, going back or we're going to go forward. I don't know about you. I'm going forward. I got my eyes on Jesus. Amen, glory to God, just your brother approach you. Amen, you just don't care about the people. Yes, if you know me long enough, you know I did. And I wouldn't have shut it down for 3 months if I didn't care for the people. But this is starting to be more political than it is anything. I'm here to tell you, yes, it's taking a lot of people out. Yes, a lot of them is lying that they died from the coronavirus. Amen, because the insurance will pay it all off. But I'm going to tell you, I don't know about you, but I'm in this thing to win. Did you hear me? Amen, glory to God. Yes, the devil loves to see the churches, all the churches, to shut down. But let the riots ride out the streets, kill people, burn everything down. But that's all right. All right. We don't take a stand. Did you hear me? The enemy's objective is to destroy the faith of those who serve Jesus. I said, God, how in the world can we turn this around, turning wimps into warriors in these last days? Help us, Lord, to stand strong and fight the good fight of faith. They told the disciples, don't mention his name no more. Amen. What did they do? They kept his mention in the name of Jesus anyway. More the church was persecuted, the more it grew. Did you hear me? God has a purpose and plan behind every trial that Satan brings to our lives. And if I put a title on the message this morning, God will never forsake his children. Did you hear me? God will never forsake you and me unless me and you walk out. Did you hear me? God will never forsake you and me. We got to stand strong because it ain't going to get no better. Did you hear me? Gloom and doom preacher, you and me ain't going to. No. It ain't gonna get no better until we hear that trumpet sound and we're out of here. Did you hear me? But while we're still here, we need to stand strong and true to, amen, our Heavenly Father and His Son Jesus. Did you hear me? Amen. Be a witness. Invite people to church. Encourage people. We do everything. We wipe down everything. We spray everything. We ain't got a bug in the house. If we do see a bug, it got by all the stuff was sprayed. God has a purpose and a plan behind every trial that Satan brings to our lives. God has a purpose and a plan. Luke 22 and verse 32, but I have prayed for you that your faith may not fail. Clearly Christ knew Peter would come out of his trial with his faith intact. The same holds true for us today. Jesus promised to pray for his disciples was made not just to Peter, but to all who would follow Christ and succeed generations. Our Lord has a plan to use every one of us out of our trials. Did you hear me? He'll never leave us. He'll never forsake us. He'll go to the end of the world. He'll stick to us closer than a brother. They'll be in the midnight hour till the joy comes in the morning. I'm going to tell you, church, he is my high tower. He is my fortress. He's my all in all. Glory to God. Did you hear me? Church, to the Lord. I pray you can. And give God the praise. We can't have stand strong. Pray, go to God. Pray. The reason the church is in the state is then because of lack of reading and a lack of praying. Where's the boldness of the children of God that used to stand? The boldness of the Holy Ghost. Now don't misunderstand me. I ain't going out looking for disease or sickness. But I sure ain't gonna be locked up in my house all the days of my life. Amen. Been scared that I get it. It better be scared that I don't get it because I'm gonna give it a rough time. Did you hear me? Church of love and compassion. Turning wimps into warriors. God help us to be strong and to do battle. Yes, Peter, he messed up, but his face remained intact. And he was used on the day of Pentecost in a great and a mighty way. Scriptures echoes Christ's warnings. Revelation 12 and 12, therefore rejoice, ye heavens, ye that dwell in them, woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is come down unto you, having great wrath, because he knoweth that he has but a short time. You think this is the Spirit of God that's burning everything down? Rioters out there, people get shot up and killed and dragged out of the cars, beat half to death. Amen. Is that the Spirit of Christ? No, it is not. It is the Spirit of the Antichrist in these last days. Church, those on Facebook, those on YouTube, listen. Amen. We're going to have what we say we got because we're going to be tested and tried. Church is powerless. Why? It's because we have forsaken. If you can't see we're right nigh at the door, you're spiritually blinded.
Yes.
We're nigh at the door of the coming of the Lord.
Amen. Lord.
They tried to get rid of the money, cashless the society, running out of coins. First Peter 5:8. Be sober, be vigilant. Because your adversary, the devil, is a roaring lion walking about seeking whom he may devour. If you got thoughts of giving up on Jesus, you better rebuke it and never let it enter to your mind again. Amen. Because he's the only one's going to see us through. 1 second in hell, you're going to regret. But it's too late. Did you hear me? What gets me is a pastor. My brother, I ain't coming to church. Amen, glory to God. You ain't got to shake hands with the elbows. Wear your mask. Wear your gloves. Wear a bubble if you have to. Did you hear me? But don't forsake yourselves in the city and yourselves in there, together in the house of God, as you see the day approaching. But yet they won't come to church with you. See them in Walmart, food line. You see them, Lord of God. I preach, I will come back, but amen, I just don't want to catch them out. Oh, I came this close, want to say, what in the world you doing in all the world? You got 200 or 300 people packed out in this store. But Lord of God, yeah. Oh, it's getting quiet, isn't it? Be sober. Be vigilant. Because your adversary, the devil's a roaring lion walking about seeking whom he may devour. Whom he may devour. In short, the devil's aim is to consume and swallow the faith of God's elect. If we allow the enemy to do so. John 10:10. The thief cometh not but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. We are told that Satan brings a flood against God's people, attempting to sweep them away, our faith, with awful fear and overwhelming attacks. Fear has swept America. It's swept in all the big churches you see on television. It got to everybody. But God said he didn't give you the spirit of fear, but of love. And a sound mind, did you hear me? Hold your Facebook, amen, your Facebook. I don't have Facebook, so don't hold your comments back. My daughter's wife has it, but I don't have one. Turn wimps into warriors. God help us to be strong in these last days. Help me, Jesus, to stand true. This ain't more than just my mouth that I love you, but let me show you on a daily basis that I have set aside to do the Master's work. Help me to steal away some time in my prayer closet. You got a prayer closet at home? They show the war room, that movie, one of the best movies they come out with. She had her own little room and had little prayer notes up in there. Amen, glory to God. Amen, it could be your bedroom, it could be your bathroom. You said, well, if my car's my prayer calls, it was good. Shut the motor off, cut the radio off, and go to God, sit there. I tell you, hear from heaven, did you hear that? Church is a call. It's a call to get back with him. It's a call. He said, I'll never leave you. He said, if anybody doesn't leave you, it'll be me and you. Did you hear me? Revelation 12 and 15, and the serpent cast out of his mouth waters as a flood against the woman, that he might cause her to be carried away of the flood. Most Christians remember Peter boast about his own faith. Lord, I am ready to go with you both to prison and to death. In Luke 22 and verse 33. What Peter says here so brashly may come across as spiritual boldness, yet in truth, it represents a kind of fleshly audacity that promotes a warning from Paul to the church. In 1 Corinthians 10, I think it's 12, let him who thinketh he stands take heed, lest he falls. At this very moment, in the midst of your storms, your pains, and your sorrows, Jesus is interceding for you. He is pleading your cause, and he has never let go of you. Just a handful of us here today. If we got back into our prayer closet, see our children come to the house of God. Our grandchildren, or mama, or daddy, or brothers, or sisters. Get a hold of the horns of the altar and begin to pray and seek the face of God. Quit saying, I love God, and we forget Him days without number. I love the Lord, but Monday come, you never spend time with Him. Amen. Tuesday, oh, I love the Lord, but don't get into His presence or open up the Word and say, God, enlighten my mind. Help me to understand. This past week, how much have we really sought the face of God? And you want to know why in the world I'm about to lose my mind, preacher? So much going on, so much bad news on television and in our communities and everything. I feel like I'm going to lose my mind. It's because you've got to get into your prayer closet. Did you hear me? When we lift Him up, He will draw all men unto Him. Amen. When we lift Him up, He will draw all men unto Him. Amen. I'm just a pastor, symbolic of a shepherd, to preach you the gospel, encourage you to live for Jesus. Encourage you to seek His face. Get into your prayer call. Open up the Word of God. Get a hunger in your heart like when you first got saved. And if we're honest with ourselves, we have let God down. Did you hear me? He said, how do you know, Brother Paul? Because it tells on us. It tells on us. With love and compassion. God will never leave us. If anybody doesn't leave us, it'll be me and you. How can we profess to be His children and never go to Him? This is not to discourage you or make you feel bad or browbeat you, whatever you want to call it. It is encouraging you to get back to your prayer closet. Get into the Word of God. Put the names in your Bible, whatever you want to do, those that are also in your household. And every time they get saved, you can take their names down because God has delivered their souls. Did you hear me? Anointed every day with the oil and say, God, save their souls. Help me, Lord of God. If I have any unbelief in me, help me. Help me, Lord, help me. Yes. To believe. rescue me. I give you something better than that. When death comes, I surely don't want to lift my eyes up in hell. Oh my goodness. How can we neglect him? Day after day after day after day. I have the scriptures going down the road. It's fine and dandy. It's not knocking to keep doing it. But where is your time alone with him that he can talk to you? Oh, we all fly.
Bless
the Lord. Amen. Bless the Lord. He said, Brother, I just don't have time. I work 8 hours a day or 10 hours a day. Time I get up. We use all kinds of excuses. And your spouse laying up here in the coffin and knowing good and well they didn't make it because you was there with them to know the fruits of them they bared in their lives. We sit back and play pancake with the devil. Everything is all right. Now he cares the church. Before service tonight, pray. Not that Brother Brooks shows up, but that the Holy Ghost would show up. That Jesus gave to Peter along with his warning. Once you have turned again, strengthen your brethren. This comes on the very heels of Jesus' warning to Peter that he would be sift. In fact, it is all in the same verse. He tells us as he did Peter, get up, go now. Do not focus on your failures. Rather, feed my sheep. Warn my precious ones about the enemy's devices at work against them. Tell them I hold them in my hands through every trial. Peter had an important work to do, and he had been equipped, furnished, experienced to preach, firsthand experience to preach the message he was called to deliver. You see, Jesus had told his church, we cannot afford to be ignorant of Satan's devices. Peter was able to speak to God's precious ones not only about the trials they would face, but about the faithful that God would, amen, who would see them through the worst of times. Psalms 46 and verse 1, God is our what? And a very present help in trouble. Give the Lord a great big hand. The friend. In the Hebrew, always sheer, always available, with unlimited access. Amen. Isaiah 59 and verse 19, so shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and His glory from the rising of the sun. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him. It doesn't matter what the devil brings against us. God's power and His people will always be greater than Satan's arrows or his shots that he throws against you and me. God is always greater. Come on, how many of you are ready? I believe it's Psalms 16, verse 7. He said, I will bless the Lord who has given me counsel, my reins, also instructs me in the night season. I have set the Lord always before me, because He is at my right hand, I shall not be moved.
Amen.
To encourage you, God will not leave us. Let it be you and me be the one that leaves. Quit reading. Quit praying. Quit going to church. The old man's going to rise up very quickly.
Amen.
And you're going to be 7 times worse than you was the first time.
Amen.
Did you hear that? With love and compassion to encourage you days without end, spend time with God at your home. Because see, it's what you bring to church. No, what you're doing at home.
Yes, amen. Yes.
Oh, God. Amen. He said that one more time. I got one amen and one said, oh, gosh.
Amen.
This is a critical time in our lives as children of God.
Yes, yes. Amen.
Yes.
To encourage you to get into your prayer closet and seek the face of God.
Yes.
And the Bible says when you do, shut the door behind you. Yes. Leave your cell phone out. Cut it out.
Yes.
We're not going to make it to heaven by the skin of our teeth. We're not going to make it to heaven because of what our last name is.
Amen.
Doesn't matter how much you gave to the poor or how many you have helped. That's good. That's commendable. But it's going to really boil down to who lives in your heart and your mind.
Amen.
This is the battlefield right here.
Amen.
Is your mind. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of God, Jesus, will lift that standard against the enemy.
Yes.
Can you see last week or the week before that how much we spend time with God at home? How much we spend in front of the television set?
Yeah.
And we don't have time for God whatsoever. I'm talking about Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. His love covers a multitude of sins. God help us in these last days. church of the living God be one of the churches, amen, that the living waters would flow in these last days. Lord, help us to be strong. How much in this passion we say we love Jesus, but we haven't spent not one ounce in prayer or even open up the Word of God. You say, I don't understand what it says, it's spiritual discernment. When we get our mind focused, anybody can understand John 3:16. In the verse after that, he said, I didn't come to condemn the world, but I come that it be saved. And I'm not trying to discourage anybody, but I'm trying to encourage you. Not on our own souls, but I love those. We might be the only ones standing in the gap there. And we got to seek His face. Jesus in the morning, Jesus in the noontime, Jesus when the sun is gone down. Did you hear me? Do you know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Today is the day of salvation, not tomorrow. Call on Jesus. Say, I'm a sinner, and I need to be saved. And repent of your sins. And ask God to forgive you and come into your heart and life. Amen. Let's